A Python dictionary is an incredibly useful data structure. While other data types, such as lists and strings, use an index to access data, dictionaries have keys to access data. The dictionary structure is called a key-value pair, where each key represents a value. A key is usually a string, but the value can be a string, integer, list, tuple, or even another whole dictionary. To better understand how dictionaries work, let's use an example of a company profile, in this case, Tesla. As the dictionary is structured as a key-value structure, we can look for a value based on its key. We can check when the business was founded by giving the dictionary the founded key within square brackets, and we get the value, which is July 1st, 2003. This is similar to using lists and indexes, but here, instead of using integers as indexes, we work with keys. What happens when we try to find a value based on a key that does not exist? We can see that if we give the non-existent key of share price, we get a key error. Alternatively, we can access dictionary values with the get method, which takes the key as a single argument. If we try our non-existent share price, the get method can return an optional value. So if the share price key is not available, we can return a message saying the information is not available instead of getting a key error. Let's say we want to add the type of company as a new piece of information to our company profile. To add a new item in the dictionary, we give the dictionary our new key, which is the type and corresponding value of public. Now if we print out the dictionary, we can see that the new information has been added. In the dictionary structure, if the key does not yet exist, then the key is created and assigned the value. If the key does exist, then it will get updated with a new value. Let's say that Tesla went private, in which we can simply assign the key type with the value of private. We can also add or append items to a dictionary with the update method. Let's say we want to add a bunch of information to our company profile dictionary, which is already in dictionary form. We will use the update method on the company profile dictionary and pass our new information dictionary as an argument. When we print the dictionary, we can see the new information has been added. Let's say we want to remove some financial information from the dictionary. We can remove an item from the dictionary with the pop or del, as in delete, method. If we need to capture the value after we remove it, we can use pop. If not, we can use del. When we use either of these methods, the key and corresponding value are removed from the dictionary. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.